The ability to appreciate beauty is an important virtue.
Elias? Long time no see. What can I do for you?
I heard that you canceled your research project, so I'm just here to ask you why.
Oh, that, it's really nothing special. I just don't feel like going anymore. I'm not the only one who canceled, right?
I mean, people have had no motivation to conduct research lately, haven't they?
No motivation to conduct research?
Yeah. Say, who might you be? You look sort of familiar.
Don't mind me. Please, continue.
Well, with the downfall of the Sages not long ago, many of the projects that they led were put on hold while they were being investigated. With the situation being so volatile, people are picking up random things to do to kill time. No one wants to risk starting any new research until it's clear how things will pan out in the future.
When you say, how things will pan out, you actually mean what the new Sages would have interest in, right?
Wow, talk about blunt. But that isn't the only reason for the lack of motivation to start new research.
So what are the other reasons?
Well, because the Akasha Terminal shut down. I'm sure you're all aware that we require all kinds of knowledge to perform any of the research we do. Back then, the Akasha would respond to any of our requests for the knowledge we needed. It was beyond convenient. We didn't have to spend an extended amount of time studying, so we were able to immediately run various tests and experiments.
I see.
You get it, right? After having had a taste of something so amazing, who can be bothered to manually sift through data and files ever again? There are only a handful of people at the academia who are starting new projects or performing research. Most people are like me, waiting for a recognized researcher to start a project before immediately applying to join. Although our names will be further down in the paper, we'll have a much easier time. We don't have to do most of the mental heavy lifting. All we have to do is focus on our assigned tasks.
Ilias? What's wrong?
My head... it hurts. I remember now. I remember what Siraj said to me as he approached. You will become Siraj number 36. Fuse yourself with a consciousness under my control. Think only in accordance with a set module. Like a worker bee in a beehive.
Paimon doesn't get it. What does that even mean?
It's what Siraj was researching and the topic of the thesis he had submitted. Collective consciousness and the path of evolution. Siraj believed that by achieving three objectives, he could create a collective consciousness in human society and drive humans toward their ultimate evolution. First, he would rank test subjects in descending order of ability, with number one serving as the overmind.
This overmind would then divide tasks into numerous modules and delegate them to the collective's members based on their assigned number and the task's importance. Lastly, this system must support the rapid exchange of information within the collective, or even better, allow its members to share their memories and emotions.
Paimon still doesn't get it. What's the point of all that?
Think of it as linking many minds together and tailoring a given mind's assigned work based on its compatibility. Eventually, everyone's minds will be consolidated into a new form of existence that is both an individual and an organization. Siraj believes this collective consciousness is superior to individual humans.
Whoa! Squishing a whole bunch of people together? Paimon thinks that sounds horrible!
It's just as Alhatham said. Siraj gave all the test subjects different numbers. Bigger numbers meant you had a lower rank, so your assigned tasks were less complex, such as being responsible for everyone's basic needs. Smaller numbers were ranked higher, so you'd be given more complex assignments like planning for the future. Siraj referred to me as number 36, and I think that was a low-ranking number. I also recall that Siraj said his plan was proceeding very quickly, and that the Hive would soon be complete. I tried my best, but that's all I can remember. I still can't recall where the cave is. I'm really sorry.
Take your time. You'll eventually remember it all. However, something doesn't seem right. some details don't add up.
What's off?
You were only designated as number 36? What a shame. From what I can see, your talents merit a smaller number. I'm not sure what Siraj's numbering system is based on. Anyway, we're done here. Let's go.
Please, wait. I heard you all talking about Siraj just now. Are you looking for him?
Huh? Do you know something?
Well, Siraj is pretty popular as of late. I heard he's gained recognition from a lot of well-known researchers. Supposedly, he's a strong contender for being one of the next sages. There are many who would give up everything to be a part of his research team. I'm nothing special, though, so I doubt I'd get the opportunity. That said, I do know a researcher who received an invitation from Siraj but declined it. Her name is Janaki. If you're interested, you can try to find her. She's usually reading at the pavilion in the garden.
Janaki, we'd like to ask you a couple of things about Siraj.
Ilias?
Do you know me? I'm sorry, but I don't recognize...
Are you playing dumb with me?
No, I'm not. I actually have amnesia, so I've lost a lot of my memories.
And? Are you trying to say that I should forgive you just because you've forgotten what you've done? Or are you using the acting Grand Sage as backup to settle things with me? The two biggest loners teaming up. What a terrible thought.
That's enough. There seems to be a dispute between the two of you, but I have no interest in that. I heard that Siraj once invited you to join his project. Is that true?
So, what if it is? Siraj did extend an invitation to me, and I was also interested in his project. I think it was about collective consciousness or something. Anyway, he said that I could be number 45. I refused because I thought that rank was too low. No one wants to be placed at the bottom. Certainly not me.
Ilias is number 36, and Janaki was supposed to be number 45. Ugh, just how many people did Siraj have his eyes on?
Tell me, did Siraj tell you how he assigned numbers?
Yeah. Remember how the sages took advantage of the Akasha and extracted Yana energy from our heads back then? They left a document that records the amount of Yana energy that the Akasha had extracted from each person. I don't know how Siraj got his hands on that document, but he used it as the basis for his numbering system.
I see. He believes that this data can be used to evaluate a person's computing power. Putting aside the validity of the data, it is meaningless to judge individuals based solely on their Jnana energy. At most, Jnana energy can only be seen as representing a portion of a person's abilities. Humans are complicated beings, so it is impossible to evaluate them using a single criterion.
See? I knew I couldn't have only been ranked as 45.
What else do you know about Siraj?
That's it. He came to me, I refused, and that was the end of it. Is there anything else you needed? If not, I'm out of here. I've had enough of this eyesore.
Please, wait. I still want to know what I did in the past.
You really forgot?
I swear, I don't remember anything.
Paimon can vouch for him. The mantra also said that he truly lost his memory.
I see. You know what? It's better this way. I get angry just thinking about it. So I really don't have the patience to fill you in. All you need to know is that you got a lot of people in trouble back then, including me. That's all I have to say. Goodbye.
And she's gone. She doesn't seem to like you very much. Do you really not remember anything?
I really don't. But after she said that, I've had this heavy feeling in my chest. I guess I did something really horrible.
Do you want to remember?
Huh?
Even though you're a witness against Siraj in this case, you've also lost your memory. No one can force you to remember if you don't want to. Even if you manage to remember, all you would need to do is feign ignorance and tell us that you tried the best you could, but to no avail.
I'm not sure what to do. Like I said before, for some reason I felt a sense of freedom when I realized I had lost my memories. But I feel like I shouldn't be allowed to go free so easily. I still want to remember everything. What should I do?
I can look up your file. Something that caused trouble for a lot of people in the past must be on file somewhere. Would you like me to look into it?
Yes, please.
All right. Then let's return to the House of Dana. We've spent enough time here, and you should go and get your paycheck. Let's split up for now. Ilias, you go and get your paycheck. The rest of you, come to the archives with me. We'll meet back here later and then head over to Gandharvaville.
Okay, thank you all.
Relax, Ilias. Being nervous accomplishes nothing.
That's true. I'm ready. No matter what I've done, I'm ready to face it. I'll also try my best to remember anything else related to Siraj. We'll put an end to all of this.
I'm holding you to that. See you later.
job.
Okay. The important files from the last few years should all be here.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Anyway, I found Ilyas's file. Let's meet downstairs.
What have I done?
This file indicates that you were once commended by the Academia for your courage and sense of justice. You were considered a hero.
Huh? Me?
Yes. Your instructor was engaging in academic fraud, and you were the one who reported him. Your report was found to be true after a series of investigations, and your instructor was brought to justice by the Matra. This incident caused quite the commotion, and the Academia sent you a commendation. What is it? Are any memories coming back to you?
No, it's just... My head feels like it's being ripped apart again. It hurts. Did I seriously do that? Then what?
Let's put this matter aside for now. It isn't directly related to Siraj, so there's no need to push yourself over it.
I'm sorry. It should have been something good to hear, but my body is instinctively rejecting it. I feel like I'll black out if I try to remember.
Take it slow. Recovering memories is no easy task. Especially when it involves memories that you don't want to remember. Just do what you think is right.
Thank you. I'm not sure how you're so calm and composed all the time, but it does make me feel more confident about the situation I'm in.
Let's head to Gundarvaville and deliver Ilyas's paycheck to his sister. Come on!
Hmm.
We should be close. Let me think. It should be this way.
Ilias, what are you doing back here?
Dad. It's nothing. I was just wondering how everyone was doing.
You sure everything's okay? Did they bully you again? It's all right. You can tell us. Ilias, what's wrong?
I'm fine. Just a minor headache. I haven't been getting much rest lately.
Back then, I told you not to be a hero. Look how things turned out. I can't imagine how things are going for you at the Academia. We've even been receiving threat letters.
You don't have to force yourself to stay at the Academia. You can always come back home.
I'm all right. I just need a little rest.
Ilias doesn't seem like he wants them to know that he has amnesia.
Hey, hey! That's enough, you two! Ilias isn't feeling well. You can keep nagging him once we get home. Ilias, let's find somewhere to talk. So, how's your headache?
It's much better now. Oh, here, it's this month's paycheck. How's everything at home?
Same old, same old. It's just that everyone's worried about you. Don't mind their nagging. Deep down, they know that you did the right thing. It's just that after hearing a lot of bad rumors about you and seeing all the threatening letters, well, they're mom and dad. Maybe they just want you to conform a bit more.
Conform?
Yeah. You don't remember? After the incident, you... Ilias? What's wrong?
Ah, I see. I remember now. Don't worry. I remember now.
You're acting a little weird today, you know? Anyway, I understand your decision. But Mom, Dad, and I just want you to be happy. I don't care if you're a hero or not. I just want you to enjoy life and relax more.
Your understanding is a great comfort to him.
Is it? That's good. Are you a friend of his?
More so these two. My name is Al-Haytham, and this is the Traveler in Paimon.
Oh, that rings a bell. At any rate, I feel more at ease knowing that my brother has friends. Would you like to join us for dinner? I just happened to buy some extra food.
Sorry, but I still have things I need to take care of.
Well, that's a shame. Okay, I'll get going then. Take care of yourself, Ilias.
Don't worry. I won't do anything to make you guys worry again.
You remember now?
Yes. I do. Thanks for that. You know, you don't seem like such a bad person.
Is that your way of conveying gratitude?
Oh, my apologies, but I meant every word. Remember when I asked at the tavern if we had ever met? I said that there was a sense of familiarity, but what I really meant was a sense of loathing.
Loathing?
Yeah, but having spent some time with you, I realize that you're not someone I dislike to that extent.
Strange, isn't it? Why did I have those thoughts at that time?
My strength is that I don't care about what others think. If you could also develop this quality, then you won't be as bothered by complicated social relationships.
It'd be great if I could think like you. But first things first, I remember where Siraj's cave is now. I'll take you there.
Really? That's great! Paima remembers that you said there are two things that you had to do. We've only checked off one, right? What about the other one? Are we not going to do that first?
There are more important things at hand. We have to stop Siraj before he completes his collective consciousness, or it'll be too late.
You're right. Let's head out.
Scanning. Where's my key? Not again.
I'll have to grab a drink with Flame Mane when I'm back in the city.
So close, so close! Stay cool! You've got it! You got it! Whew! That was a tough fight! So close, so close! What is it? What is it? Is it another Paimon?
Ad Astra. Ad Astra.
Come at me! Ha! You
Which is exactly why I took the position.
Can be turned to dust.
Silly churl, billy churl, silly billy hilly churl. Ooh.
For slacking! Not breaking a sweat!
See?
Time to fulfill my duty! No slacking off! Guide you.
The thunder falls silent. Out of my sight. You can't. This is our majesty's gift. Is it?
Feeling a little off.
The mortal plane. A fleeting dream.
No escape.
The world remains constant over the centuries. But human life is like the dew at dawn, or a bubble rising through water. Transitory. Inactivity serves no purpose whatsoever. world remains constant over the centuries. But human life is like the dew at dawn, or a bubble rising through water. Transitory. The world holds dear is but a backdrop of constant motion. I stand before it, alone and unchanging. Remains constant over the centuries. But human life is like the dew at dawn, or a bubble rising through water. Transitory. Inactivity serves no purpose whatsoever.
And that's why I've never spent a single more on any of my snacks. I want them all, fair and square. That's right.
To learn some Favonia's blade work? All right then, I'll teach you. Oh yes, I'll teach
the
you.
The world remains constant over the centuries, but human life is like the dew at dawn, or a bubble rising through water. Transitory.
Arataki numero uno ito here in the flesh.
Just for show. Just smile and nod along. I was forced to learn.
Inactivity serves no purpose whatsoever.
I don't take them that seriously.
Best flavor in the world? The sweet, sweet taste of victory. And that's why I've never spent a single more on any of my snacks. I've won them all, fair and square. That's right.
Thank you.
Don't underestimate the beetle. They can be some of the toughest little guys around. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Want to know what's on this beetle's diet? Sweat and tears, that's what. That's how it gets stronger. I think we can all learn something from that.
Knights and aristocrats share the same cultural heritage, but the knights had enough sense to do away with all the superfluous detail.
Arataki numero uno ito here in the flesh. Ha ha!
All the world holds dear is but a backdrop of constant motion. I stand before it, alone and unchanging.
Wait. Huh? No.
Wanna come over for tea? Huh?
Aristocratic etiquette is all just for show.
Toodaloo.
Just smile and nod along. I was forced to learn all of the rules by heart, but even I don't take them that seriously.
Silly churl, Billy churl, silly Billy Hilly churl.
Ooh. Book learning alone is not enough to cultivate intelligence. All those scholars in the academia are prime examples. Wait.
One client, two clients, three clients.
Whatever.
Knights and aristocrats share the same cultural heritage.
There have been many poorly written applications.
But the knights had enough sense to do away with all the superfluous detail.
I guess I'll just have to reject them all. Wait. Huh? No.
Silly churl, Billy churl, silly...
You want to learn some Favonia's blade work? Huh? All right then, I'll teach you. Oh yes, I'll teach you all right. Mark my words.
Toodaloo. Wanna come over for tea? Toodaloo. To survive hardship, you must prepare for hardship. One client, two clients, three clients. Knights and aristocrats share the same cultural heritage, but the knights had enough sense to do away with all the superfluous detail.
Time to go!
It's time for a flash freeze. Frozen.
Disengage. That's an order. Beg for mercy. Rack and ruin. Remember.
Wanna come over for tea? Silly churl, Billy churl, silly Billy Hilly churl. When the sun's out, bathe in sunlight. But when the moon's out, bathe in moonlight. Silly churl, Billy churl, silly Billy Hilly churl. Woo!
Decree, the Vision Hunt decree. What could be next?
Silly churl, Billy churl, silly Billy hilly churl. Wanna come over for tea? When the sun's out, bathe in sunlight. But when the moon's out, bathe in moonlight. One client, two clients, three clients.
To survive hardship, you must prepare for hardship. When the sun's out, bathe in sunlight. But when the moon's out, bathe in moonlight.
Strong.
Don't underestimate the beetle. They can be some of the toughest little guys around.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
Want to know what's on this beetle's diet?
Silly churl, Billy churl, silly Billy hilly.
Nowhere to run!
Wait. Huh?
Book learning alone is not enough to cultivate intelligence. Although scholars in the academia are prime.
One client, two clients, three clients.
What a view. How about a quick break so I can sketch this beautiful scenery?
The scribe's work is simple, which is exactly why I took the position.
Truth of this world. What could it be?
Hmm. There have been many poorly written applications lately. I guess I'll just have to reject them all. Wait. Huh? No. Whatever.
Speed of light!
The scribe's work is simple, which is exactly why I took the position.
What a view. How about a quick break so I can sketch this beautiful scenery?
There have been many poorly written applications lately. I guess I'll just have to reject them all.
Work-life balance, but I think this is
going out into the world and investigating, turning the unknown into the known. I miss this feeling.
Where's my key? Not again. My latest design's getting there, but there's still room for improvement. Better make my finishing touches before the deadline creeps up.
What a view. How about a quick break?
Yeah!
Come here.
Allow me!
Rack and ruin!
Beg for mercy!
Touché!
Shut up! I condemn you!
Be still! My day!
I'm getting sick of this! Go!
There's more
to win it!
We'll meet again.
Shut up!
See?
Beg for mercy.
Reinforcements have arrived. Getting sick of this.
for mercy. I condemn you. Time to go.
You lead the way. Yae Publishing House has released numerous works that lay out military strategy in a simple and pragmatic way. Those are my favorite.
Aristocratic etiquette is all just for show. Smile and nod along.
Thank you.
Everything's in place and they've taken the bait. Yes. Now to start reeling them in.
good deeds and bad. In the end, all will be placed upon the scales.
I'll uproot you!
I do try to lighten the mood sometimes, but I'm not the best judge of other people's sense of humor.
If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make an attractive and handy bookmark. The value of knowledge cannot simply be quantified in monetary terms. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. It's all part of the learning process. The value of knowledge cannot simply be quantified in monetary terms. If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make an attractive and handy bookmark. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. It's all part of the learning process. The value of knowledge cannot simply be quantified in monetary terms. If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make an attractive and handy bookmark. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. It's all part of the learning process. If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make an attractive and handy bookmark. The value of knowledge cannot simply be quantified in monetary terms. If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make an attractive and handy bookmark. The value of knowledge cannot simply be quantified in monetary terms. If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make an attractive and handy bookmark. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. It's all part of the learning process.
Entering standby mode. I hope nobody disturbs me.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember.
Shut up! Let him cross!
This is order!
Go! Rebound!
Higher, more speed!
Higher, hands on fire!
More speed! Crush!
When the sun's out, bathe in sunlight. But when the moon's out, bathe in moonlight.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember. But where are those who share the memory?
Toodaloo.
Will be mine.
I condemn you.
Order the guide.
Cross over.
Wanna come over for tea?
I condemn you!
Survive hardship, you must prepare for hardship.
Seems Linny is saying some strange things again. It's really worrying.
Thank you. Close enough.
Feeling lucky today?
You want long!
Quicker.
You are not welcome here.
This way! Out of my way!
Here you are. Well now. Allow me.
Let the magic begin! Yeah. Jeez!
Would you care to
Yeah.
If you ever have any...
Ah, you're back. Be sure to get ample rest before... At first, I couldn't get used to how quiet it is here. There's no howling desert wind or sound of bugs skittering in the rainforest. When you're trying to get sleep, it's so quiet and peaceful that you almost start wondering whether it's even real, which makes it hard to relax. Yes, I just tell myself that I'm... Though, of course, before bed every night, I still reflect on my previous bed. Don't worry. I feel much more relaxed now than I was at the academia. The point of rest is to relieve the stress and fatigue you've built up. It doesn't mean completely changing who you are. I really like it here. It's a place where I can finally enjoy a moment of peace. I'll use this time to revitalize myself and prepare for the next time I need to administer judgment.
Here. Book learning alone is not enough to cultivate intelligence. All those scholars in the academia.
Silly chirp.
Thank you.
Wait. Huh? No. There have been many poorly written applications lately. I guess I'll just have to reject them all.
Tea is ready. Now it's time for a short rest. Seems Linny is saying some strange things again. It's really worrying.
Ah.